The cornerstone elements of supercomputing in facilities are that you have to have first the space, the square footage, you have to have power, and you have to have cooling, and you also have to have the structural integrity of the facility to support the infrastructure. Lawrence Livermore has been working with supercomputing for a number of years, almost as long as the lab's been open. So with the test ban treaty, that changed things. We could no longer do underground testing of the nuclear resources, so we had to go to simulation. And simulation is the key foundation for high-performance computing. Back in 2004, we quickly realized, after 453 was completed with construction, that in order to get to exascale by 2020 timeframe, that we would have to develop a facility roadmap.
Building 453 has gone through a lot of different electrical changes. Originally, when the building was built, it was for terascale computing and it's for 208 power. The next step went to petascale computing, and that's a requirement of more 480 volt power. So we've transitioned for more commercial solutions to industrial solutions to now utility solutions.
So the latest infrastructure upgrade is called Exascale Computing Facility Modernization, and that is actually bringing in a total of 85 megawatts of power into Building 453, as well as 28,000 tons of cooling.
The existing capacity of the building, the power and the cooling, was not going to be sufficient. The upgrades that we're going to need to do to house these machines, like El Capitan and what will be ATS-6, even beyond that, will need to be done at the utility scale. So we added 18,000 tons of cooling and 40 megawatts of power.
The actual cooling tower that we specified didn't have the right structural capabilities for the area, even though it's sold all over the Bay Area.
It was deemed that it was there were structural issues with that cooling tower. So in the middle of the project, we had to select a whole new cooling tower. And during that process, we were still able to meet the schedule without any impact.
We had to face commissioning without the intended load. So cooling towers, for example, we had to test that equipment without the actual computer being here to provide the heat load, having to get enough load banks to commission the size of this cooling tower. It would have been about 40 trailers worth of load banks, which are basically large water heaters. We had to figure out what was the smallest load that we could use to commission the equipment successfully.
Working with the whole ECFM team was an awesome experience. We had to figure out a whole new way of working through different challenges such as the COVID pandemic, wildfires.
The construction managers and the contractor did an amazing job at just being flexible and adapting, which was one of the biggest keys to success. We never stopped.
We actually did a lot of virtual inspections, which helped but also didn't help. It allowed us to get into spaces where typically we're not allowed to, being too physically close to equipment. But we're able to travel more quickly and schedule things a little tighter also.
And then as far as construction, everything went very well. We had over 152,000 hours of work time with no recordable incidents, so great safety record as well. Definitely kudos to the great job the contractor did. I always joke that we really don't do supercomputing, we just do construction projects. We're either planning, designing, constructing, installing, and then retiring, and then we do that wheel again.
It takes a lot of people. It takes a lot of time. It takes a lot of effort and dedication to get something like this done.
It's no longer the day where you could go buy receptacles off the shelf or do a substation that's industry standard. Everything is pretty much custom at this level. So HPC has really grown to the utility distribution level at this point.